Good morning. Welcome to St. Faustina Parish. It is March 29th, Monday of Holy Week.
Saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
And may Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant we pray, Almighty God, that through that though our weakness would fail, we may be revived through the passion of our only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit. God forever and
ever. Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen one with whom I am pleased, upon whom I have put my spirit. He shall bring forth justice to the nations. Not crying out, not shouting, not making his voice heard in the street. A bruised reed he shall not break, and a smoldering wick he shall not quench, until he establishes justice on the earth. The coastlands will wait for his teaching. Thus says God the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spreads out the earth with its crops, who gives breath to its people and spirit to those who walk on it. I, the Lord, have called you for the victory of justice. I have grasped you by the hand. I formed you and set you as a covenant of the people, a light for the nations, to open the eyes of the blind, to bring out prisoners from confinement and from the dungeon those who live in darkness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid?
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
When evildoers come at me to devour my flesh, my foes and my enemies themselves stumble and fall.
The Lord is my light, my salvation.
Though an army encamp against me, my heart will not fear. Though war be waged upon me, even then will I trust.
The Lord is my light, my salvation.
I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord.
The Lord is my light, my salvation. With your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. 6 days before Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, where Lazarus was, whom Jesus had raised from the dead. They gave a dinner for him there, and Martha served, while Lazarus was on one of those reclining at table with him. Mary took a liter of costly perfume oil made from genuine aromatic nard, and anointed the feet of Jesus, and dried them with her hair. The house was filled with Then Judas Iscariot, one of the disciples, and the one who would betray him, said, "Why was this oil not sold for 300 days' wages and given to the poor?" He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief and held the money back and used to steal the contributions. But Jesus said, "Leave her alone. Let her keep this for the day of my burial. You always have the poor with you, but you do not have me." The large crowd of the Jews found out that he was there and came, not only because of him, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. And the chief priests plotted to kill Lazarus too, because many of the Jews were turning away and believing in Jesus because of him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. But in the gospel, the community has been absolutely your prayer.
And let's pray for our family, especially Gracie's mom and brother, and all those and her friends who are mourning her loss. Just kind of understand this, especially young people. No idea about death. This is a mystery to them. And a lot of very deep questions that they're asking. Well, let's just pray that the Lord will guide them to stay in the rest of their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And again, we pray for Gracie's mom, pray to Mary, who's a mother. Let's pray to her.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God. Pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Blessed be God for
and by the mystery of his water and wine, may we come to share the divinity of Christ, who has humbled himself to share our humanity. Now blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of your hands, it will become
blessed be God forever.
And Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from my sin. And I pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look graciously, O Lord, upon the sacred mysteries we celebrate here, and may what you have mercifully provided to cancel the judgment we incurred, there for us fruit in eternal life. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the
Let
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. And our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the days of his sacred passion and glorious resurrection are approaching, by which the pride of the ancient foe is vanquished, and the mystery of our redemption in Christ is celebrated. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning our ceaselessly had work, so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings, and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and the blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we were once lost, we could not approach you. You loved us with sooner away when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross. He took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of death.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our sure feast, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead, and looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, the sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those who unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that in the power, by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom, until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Faustina, and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. And this morning we remember Edward Colonus Sr. and Edward Colonus Jr. Then freed at last from the wound of corruption, and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity. But through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now at the Savior's command, before my divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's now share Christ's peace with one another.
Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
should enter under my roof, but only if you say the word, then my soul shall be healed.
And may the body of Christ be safe for eternal life. And now with our sisters and brothers who have prayed with us this morning from their homes, we pray an act of spiritual communion.
May Jesus bring you to our presence in the most holy sacrament.
I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you
with my soul.
Since I cannot at this moment receive you
sacramentally, come with me spiritually into my heart. I embrace you if you are already there. Unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Our prayers in
the name of the Archangel, innocent battle, your defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, God, Prince of the Heavenly Host. By the power of God, thrust into hell Satan, evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Let us pray. Visit your people, O Lord, we pray, and with ever watchful love, look upon the hearts dedicated to you by means of these sacred mysteries, so that under your protection we may keep safe in this remedy of eternal salvation, which by your mercy we have received through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May your protection, O Lord, we pray, defend the humble and keep ever safe those who trust in your mercy, that they may celebrate the Paschal festivities not only with bodily observance, but above all, purity of mind through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And the message ended, let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God. Amen.